the lady gets the pink slip, so to speak. And not only that, she tried to buddy up to her husband, and he told her to hit the road as well.
I tell you what, it was a lead pipe cinch on what happened to Goldberg. You know what I'm talking about? Let me tell you, that Texan, Mongo McMichael, finally maybe either took her home, sent her home, got rid of that mess right there, and can focus on his career. What a matchup we got coming here. Whoa.
Good point. You said focus on his career, and now maybe Alex Wright can focus on his career. And I know Deborah McMichael is drop-dead gorgeous, one of the most beautiful women in the world, but she is a meddler, and she obviously, I think, does not enhance anyone's career. She looks good to walk in the ring with you, but to me, that's about it. And I may be wrong.
Well, that's probably more to it than just walking through the ring looking good, but she does that. But focus on your career. Focus on what needs to be done, just like Ernest Miller and Glacier need to focus on this situation tonight. Sting needs to focus on Hollywood Hulk Hogan. Zabisco needs to focus, really, on the whole NWO. Eric Bischoff accepting that challenge. Tony, he wouldn't have done that if they don't have a game plan. You know what I mean?
Oh, sure. They know exactly what they're doing each and every time. They proved at World War III that, yes, they had a game plan. They have proved time and time again. They proved the last time we saw Sting on Nitro. They have a game plan. And you know they got a game plan for not only Zabisco, but for Sting coming up at Starrcade on the 28th of December as well. The lights come back on here. It's going to be, as you said, Dream, a great tag team match, because Glacier and Ernest Miller, as great a duo as they are, will face one of the true top tag teams ever. Here they come, Booker T, Stevie Ray, led by Jacqueline.
Make no mistake about it, you're looking at probably, as I said on numerous occasions, the top tag team in the early part of the 90s. The Steiners now take that step up there into that portion of iconism and tag team wrestling. These guys are great, and she really provides them with the leadership that they have always needed. She looked good walking through the ring, too. You know what we're talking about? Walking through the ring.
Yes, she is. She is certainly a gorgeous woman as well. And you see our great fans here in Toledo, Ohio, prepared for what should be a fine tag team encounter here on WCW Saturday night. As we've been saying for so long in the course of this program, Diamond Dallas and Curt Hennig to go one-on-one later on. Ming and the Barbarian are here against Wrath and Mortis. Plus, we're going to see Hacksaw Jim Duggan. Also, Rey Mysterio Jr. Glad to have you with us here on Saturday night. And immediately, if you size up this matchup, you can see the quickness, I would think, favors Glacier and Miller, but the power, obviously, with Harlem Heat.
Yeah, and how long has Glacier and Miller been together, right? You know what I mean? When we talk about tag team, you know, great athletes, well-schooled in all the arts. But, you know, we talking Harlem Heat living together, being together all the time, being four or five times world tag team champions. And that really goes a long way when you're trying to put somebody away. Got a miss there on that roundhouse kick.
That's a cover, and it's a great counter move by Glacier. That's one of Booker T's premier moves, that standing sidekick and or round kick. And when he went for it that time, not only did Glacier duck out of the way, Dream, but he did a leg sweep to take the man off his feet.
Yeah, went right down for cover, even though it was early. You know what I mean? You never know when you get a 1-2-3.
We've seen it happen early on.
Well, they're pounding on him right now.
Scoop slam, and down go Glacier. We're going to be showing the fans later on the problems that have existed now, especially after what happened in Nitro with Ming and the Barbarian in Harlem Heat. And it all transpired based on a match that Booker T had with Ming this past Monday on Nitro, when Booker T came up with what I thought was an upset win over Ming, and then the heat was on, so to speak.
Yeah. I want to tell you what, too, there's a lot of conversation, if you will, Tony, about really how bad hurt the big man is. I'm talking about the giant. You know what I mean? I mean, when you talk about a hand, hard to come back from a situation like that, especially one you use for the choke slam.
The fact that it was put in a cast, and the fact that it was beaten severely by Kevin Nash, disguised as Sting Monday on Nitro. The last thing we saw from the giant, he was face down on the mat in a lot of pain. And certainly the giant hopefully can get back and get on the men very, very soon, as well as the Nature Boy, Ric Flair.
Yeah.
I mean, take a look at our roster, Dream, and the injuries we've suffered at the hands of the NWO.
Yeah, Tony, and the more injuries you suffer this time of your career, talking about Nature Boy Ric Flair, the harder they are to get over. You know what I mean? Boy, that was nice right there. Cut him good. Can he make a tag? Fresh man, Ernest Miller, waiting on the sideline right there. Say, coach, come in. Put me in.
Can he make a tag? Glacier,
he's right there.
I'm not so sure he realizes ring positioning, but Booker T does. He's going to make a tag. Glacier can just about reach up easily and make the tag, and he ducks. And here comes Ernest Miller. Ducking low.
Nice side kick. Side kick. Chop.
Ernest Miller using the tools that has made him a success in tournament karate, and there's a great kick to put the man down. Oh, boy! How about that one?
Yeah, that was good. Stay on him now. Keep it going.
Ernest Miller to the side of the head, and Booker T had seen enough.
Yeah, see, you can. I'm telling you, they know what to do. I'm talking about Harlem Heat.
Here's the double team. How about that? He kicked both men one at a time that time.
Yeah, he got one good and glanced on the next one right there. Went ahead and tried to get a cover. But I tell you what, Glacier really took a beating there.
He really did. As a matter of fact, Ernest Miller's had to fight off two men here. Glacier went up to make a tag, and Glacier has not even come in to help his man. And Ernest Miller suffered a double team two separate times here. Glacier remains in the ring. As you said, Dream, he took a severe beating as well.
Sure he did, and he really was. Come on.
And Ernest is reaching up for Glacier, and Glacier kind of just casually stuck a hand out there. Oh! The knee pick, but there's the big apple.
Yeah.
Ernest Miller, here's a cover. One, two, three, a cover.
Yeah, wow, I'll tell you.
Glacier did not even move.
No, Glacier's just staring there. You know, he did take a lick in there, but I don't know about that. What do you read into this?
I don't know what to make of it. As a matter of fact, Harlem Heat came away with a big win. And Ernest Miller gave it all he could, but in the end, he could not fight both men alone. Now here comes Glacier in.
Well, he's going to soliloquy on us here, I think.
He's got a microphone. Boy, this is strange.
Yeah, this is real strange. We don't need no splits here. You know what I mean? Too much going on.
Hey, Ernest, now you know what it feels like for your buddy to be just a few minutes late.
Oh, my. Well, there are some real problems here for these two men.
And they're problems we don't need at WCW. I guarantee you that.
All right, let's go to the locker room area with Mean Gene Okerlund. How about that?